I'm Dr. Sanjana Vij, Assistant Professor from Amity Institute of Education, New Delhi. Today, my topic for discussion is collaborative learning. What is collaborative learning? You must have an idea, you have heard about cooperative learning and collaborative learning. So in a large and diverse educational community, collaborative learning means different things to different people. For some, the focus of the collaborative learning involves changing the classroom landscape by grouping students in pods to encouraging greater peer interaction. But for others, collaborative learning is modeled by educators who combine traditional furniture configuration with progressive teaching techniques to actively engage their students. And at many schools, it is both. So for different people, the concept of collaborative is different. But collaborative learning is a method of teaching and learning in which students team together to explore a significant questions to create a meaningful project. As the name suggests, that collaborative learning is when everyone is involved in the learning. Each and every child should be involved in the learning, then only the collaborative learning will be helpful and useful. A group of students discussing a lecture or students from different schools working together over the internet or on the discussion on or the shared assignments are the examples of collaborative learning. In collaborative learning, students work together in small groups but in a structured manner, in a structured activity. They are individually accountable for their own work and the work of the group also as a whole, and it is also being assessed later on. So cooperative groups work face to face and learn to work as a team. Now in small groups, students can share strengths and also develop their weaker skills. They develop their interpersonal skills. They learn to deal with the conflict. When collaborative groups are guided by clear objectives, students engaged in many activities that improve their understanding of subjects explored. In order to create an environment in which collaborative learning can take place, the teacher has to keep three things in mind which are most important. First is that students need to feel safe. In collaborative learning, the teacher has to create that kind of environment that students should feel secure that yes, if I am doing this particular activity, so there is no danger by doing this particular activity. So the student should feel safe but also challenged. That it is a challenging task, I must do this so that the results can be seen positive. The second main point which we have to see is that groups need to be small. If it is a very large group, then you will not find the accurate results, or the students will be, they will not come out with their outcomes. If the group is small, each and every child in that particular group will get time to show his caliber, to show his activities properly. So group needs to be small enough that everyone can contribute in that. Because once the activity is complete, they have to give the presentation. So every student should get a chance to present their work. So it is possible only in the small group. And the third, which is very important, is that the task students work together must be clearly defined. All the duties should be pre-planned and explain them beforehand so that there should not be any confusion when they are implementing actually the collaborative learning or when they are actually on the activity mode. Also in collaborative learning, small groups provide a place where learners actively participate. Teachers become learners at times and learners sometimes teach also. So it is a two-way process Respect is given to every member. There should not be, no member should feel isolated in this collaborative learning. Projects and questions entrust and challenge students. Diversity is celebrated and all contributions are valued. Students learn skills for resolving conflicts when they arise. Members draw upon their past experiences and knowledge. Goals are clearly identified and used as a guide. Research tools such as internet access are made available and students are invested in their own learning. So collaborative learning differs from traditional teaching approaches because students work together rather than compete with each other individual. So there is a difference between collaborative learning. If you compare collaborative learning with a traditional approach, then this is a major difference, because in collaborative learning you work for each other and you don't compete with each other. Because in traditional teaching you compete with each other and you want to show that I am the best, but in collaborative learning the students work together and the output is also together. Collaborative learning can take place anytime students work together. For example, when they help each other with homework. During homework, they can help each other. Collaborative learning takes place when students work together in the same place on a structured process but in a small group. So mixed skill groups can be specially helpful to students in developing their social ability. Because when we are making a group, the teacher has to keep all these points in the mind that she should divide the students in such a manner that all kind of students should distribute properly. So it will be known as a mixed skill group. So the skills needed to work together in groups are quite distinct from those used to succeed in writing a paper on one's own or completing most homework or seat work assignments. In a world where being a team player is often a key part of collaborative learning, is a very useful and relevant tool, because it is just one of a set of tools. It can easily be integrated into a class that uses multiple approaches. For some assignments, individual work may be most efficient, while for others, cooperative groups work best. Now let's take an example of collaborative learning. Rita is a primary teacher and he had read about the benefits of collaborative learning and she wanted to try it out in her class to facilitate on the theme travel in environmental education. So what all points she has to jot down, like place visited by the child or by you or by the child family members, and how is this place different from your hometown, your city, your village visited by you or your family members. How is this place different from your town, city? The student can jot down all those points. A famous dish, food items of that particular place, the language spoken at the hometown or at the town or at the village. So all these things they can combine it and they can jot down all those points. So the technique used by Rita in this example is called think, pair, share technique of collaborative learning. Think, pair and share is all about collaborative learning. Think, which means that students think independently about the questions that has been posted, forming ideas of their own. So they are developing their thinking and independently they are jotting down. Pair. Students are grouped in pairs to discuss their thoughts. They all will sit together in a pair and they will discuss about their thoughts. This step allows students to articulate their ideas and to consider those of others. Share. Students, pairs share their ideas with a larger group, such as a whole class. Once they have thought of the points, and once they have like in the last slide we have discussed pair. So in this, in the last step, they will just share what all they have jotted on the points. So students pair share their ideas with a larger group, such as a whole class, and often students are more comfortable presenting ideas to a group with the support of their partners. So in addition, students' ideas have become more refined through this three-step process, which is known as TPS, that is thinking, process, and share. Now, research also suggests that collaborative learning brings positive results because it makes the child think deeper, understand the content, increased overall achievements in the grades. Research have also found that students improved self-esteem by collaborative learning. They improved higher motivation to remain on the task. So collaborative learning helps students become actively and constructively involved in content to make ownership of his own learning and to resolve group conflicts and improve teamwork skills. There will be no problem while sharing with each other. In traditional teaching, there is a competency that I have to win from that particular child. But in collaborative learning, they have to resolve the group conflicts and they have to improve on the teamwork skills. So teamwork is very, very important when we talk about collaborative learning. I swim, you sink. You swim, I sink is not at all a collaborative learning. Smart ones tutors the slow ones. This is the collaborative learning. So there are many benefits that can be seen in the collaborative learning, that if we keep this strategy in our teaching learning process, then we as a teacher can see many benefits. Collaborative learning is fun because all students are working together, all students are involved. There is a multi-dimensional, multi-skills students involved there. So it is a kind of fun for the students. So students enjoy here and are more motivated towards work. Collaborative learning is interactive also. Students are engaged and they actively participate in the learning process. Collaborative learning allows discussions and critical thinking. So students learn more and remember what they have learned for a longer period of time. Collaborative learning requires students to learn to work together, which is an important skill for their future. Now, there are few benefits as we are discussing of collaborative learning, in which students are working towards the common goals. Academic work becomes an activity value for peers. In collaborative learning, students are motivated to help one another learn. Students are able to transfer the teacher's language into students' language for one side. Sometimes the students don't get what teacher is saying and what their friend is saying or what their group member is saying. They easily grasp it easily and it is more understandable for them. So students who explain to one another strengthens their own learning. So when the student is explaining to his peer partner, so that child is also strengthening his own learning also, because he is simultaneously teaching and he is also simultaneously learning. Now, role of the teacher in collaborative learning is very, very important. To have an effective collaborative learning group, teacher must know their students well. This is the first requirement, because in collaborative learning, the teacher has to make a proper groups. So if she is not aware about the child, she won't be able to make a proper groups. So for an effective collaborative learning groups, teacher must know their students well. That is the first point. Then grouping of students can be difficult process and it must be handled with care. The teacher has to see that in all the groups, all kind of students should be involved. Like intelligent students should also be there, slow learners should also be there, so that intelligent students can catch the slow learners or to guide them the slow learners. So the mixing of the group is very, very important, that how the teacher is doing that grouping. So that needs to be handled with lots of care. Teacher must consider the different learning skills, cultural background, personalities, and even gender when arranging collaborative groups. Much time is devoted to prepare the lesson for collaborative learning, because the teacher has to prepare the lessons in which activities are also involved and all the students must be involved. This is a difficult process and must be handled with the care. So, however, once the group work begins, the teacher's role immediately shifts into that of a mentor, facilitator, or sometimes merely that of a spectator. So she has to give the responsibilities slowly and slowly to the students, and she should stand as a mentor, as a facilitator. When his or her help is required, then she should approach, or the student should approach there. I am not saying that teacher should totally, teacher should be removed from that particular class. No. She will be there acting as a mentor, facilitator, and sometimes as a spectator. The children will learn from their peers and eventually will become less dependent on the teacher for help. Instead, will learn to probe a problem with the help of peers. So, very, very important point for collaborative learning is the layout and the furniture. The layout and furniture you have to keep in mind while conducting this particular activity, because the furniture should be in a different manner. So when we are selecting the furniture, we need to consider few points in our mind, that how the space will be used, what age group of the children will be using this kind of space. Is the space enclosed and separate or in an open common area? Is the furniture the correct size for the age groups of the children? So all these things we have to keep in our mind, that the furniture, and you have to see that the furniture should be practical, should be functional and appropriate for the age group using the space. So one has to be creative in thinking while selecting the furniture. It should be versatile and easily movable, so the space can be easily converted from different uses. Because when the students are discussing together, so they need maybe a round table to sit and discuss with each other. Or when they are giving the presentation, they don't want this kind of round table. So it should be a movable furniture, so that it should fit for each and every activity. Movable furniture helps to create a multifunctional learning spaces. That is more important. So we have to see the furniture and layout of the class for collaborative learning. Now there are few principles for collaborative learning, which are the basic of collaborative learning. The first one is positive interdependence. The second is face-to-face interaction. Third is individual and group accountability. Then interpersonal and small group skills. And the last one is group processing. So now I will take one by one all these five steps in and elaborate. What is positive interdependence? Now positive, when we talk about the positive interdependence, it includes sharing a common team goals. So it includes a common team objectives, sharing common resources, creating common identity for the group, for example, a name for the group selected by the members, and so on. The emphasis is on the positive emotions and attitudes reflecting through helping, encouraging each other. Students must feel that they need each other in order to complete the group task. So they need mutual goals, joint rewards, shared materials and informations, and assigned roles. Second point is face-to-face interaction. Students promote each other's learning by helping, sharing, and encouraging efforts to learn. Students explain, discuss, and teach what they know to classmates. Teachers structure the groups so that students sit knee to knee and talk through each aspect of the assignment. In traditional teaching, every student is busy and involving in their own work and they are eager to complete their own work. But in collaborative learning, this is not the scene. Face-to-face interaction is very, very important. Individual and group accountability. It is important that there is a task for each and every child, and also there is some task to be completed as a group together. Because initially you can give the task which the individual child has to complete, but later on that individual task should be discussed in the group and presented in a presentation manner later on. For example, different team members can be given responsibilities to collect different items like pebbles, fallen leaves, articles made from rubber, etc. But then the whole group must be responsible for putting the collection in order in a sequence manner, in a systematic manner, and the team together can also decide a name for the collection. Group cannot function effectively if students do not have and use the needed social skills. So that's why interpersonal and social group skills are very, very important. Teacher teach these skills as purposefully and preciously as academic skills, because this will go them with the long way and will help in the long way. Collaborative skills include leadership qualities, decision making, trust building, communication, and conflict management skills, which is the need of the society nowadays. Group processing. Groups need specific time to discuss how well they are achieving their goals and maintaining effective working relationships among members. Teachers structure group processing by assigning tasks like list at least 3 members' action that help the group be successful and list 1 action that could be added to make the group even more successful tomorrow. Teacher also monitor the groups and give feedback on how well the groups are working together in a group or in a class as a whole. This is the work of group processing. So to include, I would just like to say that collaborative learning is about supporting children work in teams. It may be small or big. So collaborative learning has social benefits as well as academic, because the child improves their social benefits and academic benefits also. They learn so many things which are apart from academic things and which will help in their future to go ahead and to achieve heights. One of the essential elements of cooperative learning is the development of social skills. So children learn to take risk and are praised for their contribution. They are able to see point of view other than their own, and they respect their point of view. It's not like that whatever you have said is correct. So they respect others' point of view also. So such benefits contribute to the overall satisfaction of learning and schooling. Students work with classmates who have different learning skills, cultural background, attitudes and personalities. So when the students are working with such a huge elaborated scenario, then definitely his or her personality will be totally different. Heterogeneous groups promote students' learning, and these differences compel them to deal with conflicts and interact with each other. So social interaction improves communication skills also, and that becomes a necessity of the functioning in the society. So this is all about collaborative learning. Thank you.